To our fourth match here of the HSBC BWF World Tour Finals. And it's yet more men's doubles here. Fajar Alfian and Muhammad Rian Ardianto of Indonesia taking on Korea's Kang Min Hyuk and Seo Seung Jae. Which is, of course, they are the current world champions. This is the situation in Group B. Alfian and Ardianto have won 2 out of 2. So they're in a very good position. Seo Seung Jae and Kang Min Hyuk lost to Astrup and Rasmussen. So they really do want to try and win here today. And that would make things, of course, very interesting, because then if Astrup and Rasmussen beat Fikri and Maulana, then we could have all three on 2 points. But Kang and Seo not worrying about that. They just have a job to do here. They want to win this. Of course, if they don't win, and, it's going to be a little bit difficult. We have perhaps a three-way shootout for that semi-final. See how this one pans out, because Indonesians are in a very comfortable position, I think, overall. A bit like what we saw with Liu Chen and Oshuan Yi earlier. It's tight, isn't it? The head-to-head, 3 apiece. The last time they met, the Australian Open, Kang and Seo won that. Just before the World Championships. So Fajar Alfian up first. He is 28 years of age, from the major city of Bandung, the second biggest in Indonesia. 75 centimeters tall, currently fifth in the world. They've slipped a bit, these guys, but about a year ago they were the world number one pair. They finished third at the World Champs in 2019 and 2022. Got the gold in the Thomas Cup in 2020 as well. Here's Muhammad Rian Ardianto. Asian Championships last year, they finished third. They've got SEA Games bronze in 2017. He's 27 from Bantul. They have won 10 titles together. We'll tell you more about what those titles are and when a little bit later on. Now for their opponents from Korea, Kang Min Hyuk. He's, maybe the less well-known of the two. 24 years of age, about 6 foot. Currently sixth in the world. They were fourth just about 6 months ago. World champs. In Copenhagen, of course, that's what they're best known for. He's a former Asian champion bronze medalist in 2019 when they had different partners. And Seo Seung Jae. He's the man at the moment, really, isn't he? The double world champion. The 26-year-old from Jeonju, in both mixed and men's doubles. Also about 6 foot. And together they have won 3 titles as a pair. 10-18. Beat Vickery and Marlana very comfortably and lost to Rasmussen and Astrup in a fantastic, one of the matches of the tournament so far, I've got to say. The crowd really got into it. Alfian and Ardianto, those are the results. Didn't have those earlier. Trish Gubb from New Zealand is our umpire. She'll be supported by Rahana De Silva of Sri Lanka. Yeah, Alfian and Ardianto have won both their matches against their fellow Indonesians and against Rasmussen and Astrup. And on my left, let's see the tone is set early on. Nice start from the Indonesians. Semi-finals. Boy, would he love to do the double effectively twice here, both the world champs and in the World Tour Finals. That would be something. The fact that he's still in contention on the final day of the group stages just shows how well he's playing overall. Excellent so far from Alfian and Ardianto. As I said, every single one of these matches today in court two, we've had, it's all been doubles matches of some sort. One pairs really had quite the start. And without maybe jinxing anything, it's the pair that starts well that actually goes on to win the match. That's been the pattern so far today. 2-5. See if that is bucked now. into this. A couple points in this then. And Ardianto just want to keep that momentum going. Nicely done by Kang Min-hyuk. That early advantage is slowly getting whittled away. Only the 1 point now. Mercy number Kang and Seo. It's really good defending there. The Indonesians can be relentless. Perhaps some of the other matches we've seen, and I mentioned them earlier, they've managed to drag themselves back into it. They haven't sort of been lost very quickly, which we saw elsewhere. As of now. Good position there. Come on, Ardianto, finish that off. flourish there. Perhaps could have done a bit better with that one. Hey! Just a bit long. Why that is significant is it's the first time that the Koreans have actually taken the lead here. So much closer feel about it. Twice a day, high intensity. It's the best of the very best.
11-9.
He's doing a good job. The Koreans are up here. 11-9.
Yang depan jaga silangannya, silangannya. Ya, nggak perlu kecepatin dulu. Ya, coba kalau bola belum bisa netting, ya netting dulu. Panjangin dulu, kan. Kalau udah bisa netting, netting dulu. Ya, ya. Kalau nonton nggak mati-mati, ya tetap kerennya. Ya.
Missed that one, Sio. 12-11. Yeah, it was a good one.
So, over.
It was
12-4.
To exploit in the backcourt with the Koreans, the left-hand side. I thought that was the right call, just a little too much on it.
13.
Now a lot tighter. Remember, the lead was decent at one stage. Oh.
Service over.
The Koreans have just started to get to their groove.
13-5-3.
Sometimes Kang and Shuk can be slow starters, slow burners. Look at that for defending. Well, that has got to be frustrating. You're pounding them. They're still coming back at you, and then you end up losing the point. Take a firm grip of this opening game since the interval. Gone for the flick serve. It's out.
16-14.
Now, we haven't had anyone take a 2-point lead at this stage yet after the interval, so this could be valuable. Alfian and Ardianto. Build on this. Up to three. Well, the Koreans have to do something here, otherwise last game was in danger of running away. Looking at that head-to-head between them, and it's 3-3, as we said. World number five, the Indonesians versus the correct Koreans. Just going back to my point about the head-to-head. Australian Open and Korea Open and the Malaysia Masters, as well as the All England and the Malaysia Open 5 times this year. And they have almost alternated on the wins. 4 game points here for Alfian and Ardianto. Ardianto, they take the game here. That puts him in a very good position. If there was to be any kind of counting back later, perhaps.
18-20.
That would happen, of course, if Kang and Seo won. Then Rasmussen and Astrup won. We could have 3 pairs on 2 points each. 2 wins each. Going into those jump smashes. From Ardianto. But they've saved yet another game point here, the Koreans. Out of the defending has been brilliant. That was Indonesians on the back foot. Oh, what a rally! It went one way, then the other. Indonesians then were with the rear guard action, they almost got away with it. We're all square at 20 all. Perfect height there for Kang Min Hyuk to finish off. So now a winner required by 2 clear points. To the net, there's Seo Sung Jae. Being challenged, but it looks like the Koreans have taken the first game. We'll wait and see now. We hear something snap as well in all of that, but very much in. And having trailed by 3 game points, Kang and Seo have won 5 in a row. Excellent for the Koreans. They've taken the first game, 22-20.
kira-kira nggak bisa ambil, lepas aja. Tadi kalau bisa diambil, asal pelan dulu, jangan setun dulu. Ya, kalau utak atik itu depannya bukanya pelan ini, siap, pasti dia udah utak atik. Tapi kalau udah netting tipis, tunggu depannya. Ya, satu. Kedua, waktu nyerah, yang belakang tunggu belakang lagi. Depan, lurus, lurus, jangan lurus lagi. Yang depan jaga silangnya. Jaga silang, jangan terlalu ke depan, karena kan dia kencang terus tuh. Ya kan, enak kencangnya kalau satu dulu aja, tutup, cepat tutup. Ya, dan defense-nya. Ya, kalau lewat nggak apa-apa lurus dulu lah, tapi ada silangnya. Tapi kalau udah tertekan banget, kalau udah tertekan banget ya.
Ya, 서비스 초보 넣었을 때 상대방이 앞에 붙이는 동작들이 많으니까 그 동작을 좀 직선 플레이 말고 배가 붙이더라도 배가 플레이에서 아니면 때릴 수 있는 상황을 좀 배가 좀 조금 좀 넓게 활용을 해보고.
So an entertaining first game here with the Koreans just edging the Indonesians, who had three game points in hand and spurned them all.
Play.
Really fast aside. That momentum. So SMJ has got to the final before of the World Tour Finals of 2020.
Challenges for
Joe. Called out, already an early challenge.
Challenge unsuccessful.
That was clearly out.
One challenge remaining. Service over. One all. Play.
Record of the season finals, semi-final appearance last year. Appearance so far. To finals. And, well, as of now, still looking like they should be able to do it. Of course, it does depend on what happens in the other semi-final. That match, by the way, Ostrobon Rasmussen versus Shohibul Fikri and Vargas Molana is happening here on court two, match number six. That'll be starting at 5 p.m.
Three, two.
Again, a similar feel, this one. power there from Seo Seung Jae. Point lead here, Kang and Seo. Early days, but got a bit between their teeth. Like I said, a win here really gives them a great shot at getting through.
Six, seven.
Still partially in their control. Favour from perhaps their fellow Indonesians.
Seven.
Oh. No one's really been able to embark on a big run. Still that 2-point lead. It's an awkward one, wasn't it, to play? Alfian actually did quite well. By the way, Ardianto has just challenged that. He had a very good look at that. I thought it was out as well, actually. Oh! Just out. Great challenge.
Service over. 8-9. Play.
Little cushion is helping them perhaps.
Yeah.
Ardianto have managed to just chip away at that. Are the ones who go in front. They've had the lead for some time. It's just a point though, and they are trailing by a game here against Kang and Seo. Now it's Indonesians who have edged in front. The biggest lead anyone's had in this second game could be really valuable. Alfian Ardianto, they will remember what happened earlier when they had a 3-point lead at the end of the last game and lost it. Done from Kang Min Kyuk. It's the 5-point run that comes to an end for the Indonesians. They were 8-10 down, so good work from them. Koreans want a run of that now if they can. Too long.
So over 14-11.
Again, he's got soft hands there, Kang Min Kyuk.
12-14.
Now behind, trying to hunt this down. Played Korean pairs 9 times this year. They've won 6 out of 9. It's for the Koreans. Oh. Third Indonesian set 14 times, won 7 and lost 7.
14-15.
Coming into this tournament. Now, is this that moment? Can't take the lead yet, the Koreans. This is kind of similar to where we were in the last game. The Indonesians had just edged in front, had those three game points, couldn't make it count.
19-16.
Oh, looked a bit dumbfounded there. Back here again. Well, well wide that one, Kang Min-hyuk. So the right shot point selection.
16.
Three, four game points this time. The Indonesians had, remember, they couldn't hold on to it last game. We could well be aiming for a fourth game, a third game, excuse me. With his four game points in hand. There's one.
Service over. 17, 20.
Go for it, the Indonesians, and they do take the game. We are going into a third for the first time today here in court two. Indonesians have played well here. Perhaps this is the end that they all seem to prefer. We'll see.
Oh,
서부터 집중해서 공을 올리고
Final game. Love ball. Play.
Into our third match now. Here we are. Third game, rather. And it's men's doubles. Group stage match. Just HSBC World Tour Finals 2023.
One. Love.
Thought the momentum might be with the Koreans. They looked good just towards the end of that last game. Has helped both pairs where the Koreans are now. So if that was to be the case, conventional thinking would be that they try to get as big a lead as they can before switching ends at the halfway point. Extra game that may have come to the equation as well. It's going to be interesting to see.
Service over. 3-2.
What a shot from Kang Min Hyuk.
Over. 3. All. Over.
Put away by
Four.
Alfian.
Three.
Has been tit for tat, isn't it? The way this has been played out.
Oi!
4.
You ought to be getting over. By two Koreans, which they had plenty of before. Plenty of times they had that in the last game.
Seven.
That was up to three. That's something they didn't enjoy earlier.
Ready?
Is three. Got the interval coming up pretty shortly. Make the most of this, the Koreans.
Let's
cut to two.
Six, eight.
Restore that 3-point lead.
Six.
Looking quite good for Kang and Xiao, isn't it, right now? The high-profile titles to boast of until that World Championship victory, which changed everything, and the road and the confidence of that to win in Australia as
11,
well.
6,
they
interval.
Are leading here, 11-6. At the interval of game three, the 5-point lead. If we were to follow what we were saying earlier, that is pretty sizable.
Eleven, six. play.
Right, post-interval session here on the third game. The match between Alfian Ardianto and Kang and Seo. Nice 5-point lead for the Koreans. Is now to six. Legends, of course, Legion up in all England wins big ones. Towards the start of the year. Then ran off the boil a little bit. Looking to just get
13,
a bit more
six.
Consistency. It's been very good for Kang and Seo. Since the break. Excellent smash down the line.
Six.
This has run away from them very quickly. Everything is going the Koreans' way suddenly. That just skims over the net, doesn't it? There's a little dance on that tape. Falls over on the right side as far as the Koreans are concerned. 9 points now. Snatching at that one. This is so different to what we've seen in the previous games. Run at the moment. Stop drop doesn't work this time for Kang Min-hyuk. That run has finally come to an end, but the damage looks like it's already been done.
And
it doesn't last very long. Very so wayward by Kang Min-hyuk.
8-18.
Clipping the net along the way.
9-18.
Almost there, Kang and Seo.
Over.
they are hanging on by a thread here, Alfian and Ardianto. Look at that, we've got 10 match points here. Oh, just out, they're not going to bother challenging on that one. The stop drop again, nicely done there. Kang Min-hyuk, the world champs, are back in business. They've beaten Alfian and Ardianto. It's taken them three. Level on points. By virtue of the head-to-head now, they are ahead of Alfian and Ardianto. So it'll be interesting to see what happens later on between.